fast you were going.
What? How fast you were going?
I don't know. 10?
8.
Be advised, this is an explicit podcast, so if you're easily offended, get your panties twisted into a knot. Turn this off before you get butthurt and mad, start to cry, have to run to your safe space. All opinions are those of the host and his guest, and do not reflect the opinions of any government agency. Welcome to the MOTORCOP Chronicles podcast. I'm your host, Iceman. This is an unfortunate time at the beginning of the month where I do the end of watch episode, ones I do not look forward to doing. It's the end of watch episode for February 2022. It's 24 end of watch deaths this past month, which is down from last month, January at 38, but still too high. But at least it is a smaller number. So we'll start to read their names and the information about them and show them, excuse me, the honor and respect they deserve. So let's give them what I can give them. Start off February 1st. Tuesday, end of watch was for police officer Chris Bardwell. He was from Crossroads Police Department, Texas. Cause of his death was COVID-19. He was 52 years old, 28 years on the job. His badge number was 007. He survived by his wife and two children. We have Deputy Sheriff LaQuentin J. Wilson. End of watch was Tuesday, February 1st, 2022. Cause of death was COVID-19. He worked for the Jefferson County Sheriff's Office in Texas. He was 39 years old, had 15 years, 7 months on the job. I think he contracted it or went to the hospital on January 14th of 2022. He is survived by his wife, two children, and a stepchild. Next, we have police officer John Painter from the Bridgewater College Police Department, Virginia. End of watch was Tuesday, February 1st, 2022. Cause of death was gunfire. He was 55 years old. Said police officer John Painter and a civilian campus safety officer J.J. Jefferson were shot and killed while responding to a call involving a suspicious person carrying a duffel bag in a restricted area of Memorial Hall. Officer Painter and CSO Jefferson contacted the subject. After a short interaction, the man opened fire on them, fatally wounding both. The man fled on foot into the town of Bridgewater. He was taken into custody. After wading onto an island in the North River, the man was a former Bridgewater College student. He was charged with 2 counts of capital murder and additional felonies related to the incident. So he died from some crazed student, obviously. Next, we have Sergeant Arthur Duran from the Fowler Police Department in California. End of watch was Wednesday, February 2nd, 2022. Cause of death was COVID-19. He was 46 years old, 14 years on the job. He survived by his wife and 4 children. We have Correctional Officer 3, Helen May Smith from North Carolina Department of Public Safety. Division of Adult Corrections and Juvenile Justice, North Carolina. End of watch was Thursday, February 3rd, 2022. Cause of death was a heart attack. She was 53 years old. She'd been on the job for 3 years and 2 months. She is survived by her husband and 2 children. We have Sergeant Chris Jenkins from the London or Loudoun County Sheriff's Office in Tennessee. End of watch was Thursday, February 3rd, 2022. Cause of death was vehicular assault. He was 53 years old, 20 years on the job, also a military veteran. Says Sergeant Chris Jenkins was struck and killed by a tractor trailer while attempting to move a ladder from I-75 near mile marker 74. The ladder had fallen off the back of a utility truck and created a traffic hazard on the interstate. Sergeant Jenkins had brought traffic to a stop with a rolling roadblock and then exited his vehicle to remove the ladder. An oncoming tractor trailer was unable to stop and struck Sergeant Jenkins, his cruiser, and several other vehicles. The vehicle that dropped the ladder never stopped. The driver of the truck that struck him was charged with vehicular homicide by intoxication, vehicular homicide by recklessness, two counts of reckless endangerment, DUI, simple possession of narcotics, possession of a handgun under the influence, and possession of drug paraphernalia. Sergeant Jenkins was a military veteran and had served with the county sheriff's office there for 20 years. He survived by his two children. His son also serves as a deputy with the agency. Sergeant Jenkins also had a cousin, Deputy Sheriff Jason Scott, who was shot and killed in the line of duty on March 12, 2004, while also serving with the same sheriff's office. We have Captain Colin Burney from the Flint Police Department in Michigan. End of watch was February 4th, 2022. Cause of death was an automobile crash. He was 53 years old, 26 years on the job, also a military veteran. He was killed in a vehicle crash on Elms Road between Mount Morris Road and Francis Road. An oncoming vehicle was attempting to pass other cars when it lost control and struck his department vehicle head on. He was a U.S. Marine Corps veteran in Operation Desert Storm. He served with Flint Police Department for 26 years. He survived by his wife and two daughters. A very unnecessary death there. Next is Chief of Police Richard Leslie Stevens, Union City Police Department, Oklahoma. End of watch February 4th, 2022. Cause of death was COVID-19. He was 54 years old, 25 years on the job. He is survived by his wife, three children, three grandchildren. His son is also a police chief in Oklahoma. We have Agent John Dale Stayrook, however it's pronounced, Medina County Drug Task Force in Ohio. End of watch was Sunday, February 6, 2022. Cause of death was COVID-19. He was 60 years old, 19 years on the job. He survived by his wife, son, daughter, brother, sister, and two grandchildren. We have Correctional Officer Braxton Hoffman of the Lake County Sheriff's Office, South Dakota. End of watch was Monday, February 7th, 2022. He died from COVID-19. He was only 23 years old, 3 years on the job. He survived by his parents and three brothers. Very young man. We have Police Officer John Mestis, Double Oak Police Department, Texas. End of watch was Monday, February 7th, 2022, he died of COVID-19. He had 45 years on the job. He was 45 years old with 15 years on the job. He was a military veteran. He is survived by his wife and four children. We have Corporal Shelley Godbold of the Pantego Police Department in Texas. End of watch was Thursday, February 10th, 2022. Cause of death was COVID-19. She was 54 years old, 13 years on the job. She survived by her daughter. We have Corporal Michael R. Springer of the Arkansas State Police Department in Arkansas. Friday, February 11th, 2022. Cause of death was COVID. He was 59 years old, 33 years on the job, military veteran. He is survived by his wife, two daughters, two grandchildren, and a sister. We have Officer James McWhorter, Florida Department of Agriculture and Consumer Services, out of Florida. End of watch was Saturday, February 12th, 2022. Cause of death was an automobile crash. He was 31 years old, 2 years, 6 months on the job. So he was killed in a vehicle crash near the agricultural inspection station on I-95 in Yulee, Florida. He was crossing from the northbound inspection station to the southbound inspection station when his vehicle was struck by an oncoming pickup truck at about 8:30 p.m. All of the occupants of the truck suffered non-fatal injuries. Excuse me, I'm tongue-tied. He served with the Department of Agriculture for 2.5 years. He survived by his 4 children and his fiancée. We have Police Officer Lonnie Sneed from the Double Oak Police Department, Texas. End of watch was Tuesday, February 15th, 2022. Cause of death was COVID-19. He was 50 years old, 15 years on the job. He is survived by his wife and 5 children. We have Corporal Keith Morgan from the Cherokee County Sheriff's Office in Alabama. End of watch was Wednesday, February 16th. Cause of death was COVID-19. He was 49 years old. Tour duty is not available. I'm sorry, he had been on Sheriff's Office for 12 years. He survived by his wife and 2 daughters. We have Deputy Sheriff Jarrett Orza. Probably pronouncing that wrong. I apologize. End of watch was February 17th, 2022. He's with the Washoe County Sheriff's Office in Nevada. He was 37 years old, 8 years on the job. He died from COVID-19. He is survived by his parents, 2 sisters, 5 nieces, and nephews. We have Corrections Deputy Bridget Lachelle Hunter from the Shelby County Sheriff's Office, Tennessee. End of watch was February 17th, 2022. Cause of death was COVID-19. Miss Hunter was 57 years old. She had 30 years and 5 months on the job. She has survived by her 2 children. She had a whole career and did not get to enjoy any retirement. It's very sad. We have Police Officer Nicholas Vela from the Huntington Beach Police Department, California. End of watch was Saturday, February 19th, 2022. Cause of death was an aircraft accident. He was 44 years old, 16 years on the job. Says he was killed in a police helicopter crash at about 6:30 p.m. He and another officer were responding to provide aerial support to the Newport Beach Police Department at the scene of a fight call. The helicopter lost altitude and crashed into Newport Bay near 18th Street. Officer Vela and his partner were both pulled from the helicopter and transported to a local hospital where he succumbed to his injuries. He is survived by his wife and his daughter. We have Sergeant Matthew Horton from the Ocean County Sheriff's Office, New Jersey. End of watch was February 22nd, 2022. He died from COVID. He was 41 years old, had 14 years, 6 months on the job, was a military veteran. He is survived by his wife and his 4 children. We have Deputy Constable Neil Adams from the San Jacinto County Constable's Office, Precinct 1 in Texas. End of watch was Wednesday, February 23rd, 2022. Cause of death was gunfire. He was 62 years old, had 10 years on the job. Deputy Constable Adams was shot and killed with his own service weapon after being attacked inside of the Plaza America's Mall in the 7500 block of Bel Air Boulevard of Houston at about 4 p.m. He was working a secondary employment assignment at the mall when the employees of the store called him for a disorderly subject whose credit card had been declined. He was talking to the subject when the man, who operated a local boxing gym, punched him without warning. After Deputy Adams fell to the ground, the man disarmed him and shot him multiple times. The man then fled to the mall's food court, where he was shot and killed by two Houston police officers when he approached them while armed with the edged weapon. Deputy Adams had served with the county constable's office for 2 years and was assigned to the agent's environmental officer. He had previously served with the county sheriff's office for 8 years. He survived by his wife. When these don't make y'all mad, I don't know what will. Police officer Jorge David Alvarado Jr. from the Salinas Police Department, California, end of watch, was Friday, February 25th, 2022. Cause of death was gunfire. He was 30 years old, 6 years on the job, military veteran. He was shot and killed during a traffic stop near the intersection of Griffin Street and East Market Street. The driver of the vehicle he had stopped immediately got out of his vehicle and opened fire on Officer Alvarado before he exited his cruiser. He returned fire from inside his car, wounding the subject before being mortally wounded. The man was taken into custody a short time later. He was charged with murder with special circumstances and shooting at an occupied vehicle. He was a U.S. Army veteran and had served with the police department for 2 years. He had previously served with the Como Police Department for 4 years. He is survived by his mother and his fiance. Detective Michael W. Goodwin from New Hanover County Sheriff's Office in North Carolina. End of watch was Sunday, February 27th. Cause of death was COVID-19. He was 41 years old, 9 years, 5 months on the job. He survived by his wife. We have Sergeant Joshua Caldwell from the Arkansas Department of Corrections. End of watch was February 28th, 2022. Cause of death was gunfire. 29 years old, 9 years, 3 months on the job. Says he was shot and killed while assisting another county sheriff's office with a canine track. Deputy said responded to a home to perform a welfare check on a woman who failed to show up at work. The sheriff's office requested assistance from the Department of Corrections to conduct a canine track when the home was found vacant. He is the canine officer. The sergeant led the officers to a trailer on Oversight Road. As they approached the trailer, a man hiding underneath the trailer opened fire on them, fatally wounding Sergeant Caldwell. The man then fled but was captured the following day. The woman was later found safe. He had served with the Department of Arkansas Department of Corrections for 9 years. He was assigned to the Tucker unit. He is survived by his wife and his three children. Lieutenant Scott Brandon Owens, Union City Police Department, Oklahoma. End of watch was Tuesday, March 1st. Oh, I'm sorry. That'll be next month. Okay, come to the end at least. There is already two for this month. There were two canines that were two canines. We had K-9 Nitro the second from New York County Sheriff's Department in New England. End of watch was Tuesday, February 8th, 2022. Cause of his death was vehicular assault. He was a Dutch Shepherd. Well, she was a Dutch Shepherd. She was female. She was 1 year, one year old, 6 months. She was killed in a vehicle crash when a subject stole her handler's vehicle and intentionally drove into another car and a passing train on Delaware Avenue. Deputies had responded to a vehicle driving erratically around 11 p.m. and attempted a traffic stop. Driver refused to stop and led deputies on a pursuit with speeds exceeding over 100 miles an hour. The subject suddenly stopped and exited his vehicle. He disobeyed officers' commands, concealed his hands, and stated he wanted to die. He was able to get into a patrol car containing nitro and fled. The stolen patrol vehicle stopped on the railroad tracks as the train approached. As soon as the train was close, the subject proceeded north and the oncoming train blocked the officers on the south side of the tracks. The man drove a short distance away, turned around, and headed back toward the train at a high rate of speed. He intentionally drove into the bystander's vehicle, pushing it into the train and killing its driver and K9 Nitro. The subject was also killed in the crash. He'd been on the dog and been on patrol for 6 months. And then we have K9 Maya from the West Jordan Police Department in Utah. End of watch was Thursday, February 17th, 2022. Cause of death was gunfire. It's a Belgian Malinois female, 6 years old. She was shot and killed on Redwood Road in South Jordan about 7 p.m. while attempting an apprehension of an armed man who had been the subject of an eight-hour-long manhunt. At 11 a.m., the West Jordan Police Department received a report that a man had assaulted a woman and was holding her at gunpoint. The woman was able to escape, and while the man chased her, officers were able to intervene and rescue her. The man then entered a vehicle and led officers on a vehicle pursuit. Due to safety considerations, the officers terminated the pursuit. They located him a short time later, and another pursuit ensued, but was also terminated for safety reasons. Officers contacted the subject by phone. The man pretended to surrender, but then fled again, starting another pursuit. Spike strips were successfully deployed, causing the vehicle to come to a stop. The man then exited the car and fired at officers. K9 was struck and transported to a surgical center where she succumbed to her injuries. Officers returned fire and killed the subject. She had been on a job for 6 years. You know, that is, thank God that is it for this month. I'm hoping next month there's even less. I know I already have two. I don't know, they had a whole bunch of these. Some of these did not just completely make you extremely mad. I don't know what will. I didn't know what to say about them. I guess got some that just have angered me immensely. So that'll be it for this. This one, I'm glad it's short. I hope they get shorter. I hope they get short enough where I don't even have to do it one day. Other than that, come back Sunday. We do have a special treat for y'all. So I'm going to have a listener. She'll be called in and asking me questions that I have no idea what the questions are, and so going in blind. So it ought to be interesting. Y'all come back for that. Other than that, keep all these people in your mind, thoughts and prayers if you are a Christian person, and keep the, especially the families and all these kids and stuff in mind. Lost their dad, mom, grandpa, people's brothers and sisters, and we'll just end it on the last call as I usually do, and see y'all in a few days.
Market and Lamar, Market and Lamar. Assist officer, shots fired. Okay, code 3, stay off the radio. Officer down. Shots fired, officer down. It's an assist officer.
No time, no time.
All right, we just don't know where the suspect's at. Saying the suspect has a rifle.
Come out here, we got a guy with a long rifle. We don't know where the hell he's at.
Slow down! He's in the damn building right there! Don't know where he's at! He's in that building! We're hearing shots from that building!
Thank you for the
we got a suspect down!
Shot fired! Officer down! Shot fired! Officer down! Got a city officer down! Shot fired! Shot fired!
That just makes it through it all. This is my last call. forgive me. Tell her I'm sorry. That I can't be. Man, that she's gonna be here. Tell her I'll be waiting where the winter meets the fall. This is my last call. And tell my children that I love them. Oh, yeah, the daddy always loved them so. Tell them the whole mother tired and I never let her go. Tell them I'll always be watching, looking over them through it all. This is my last call. But tell them to fight for me. Do what's right for me. Don't ever forget me. Tell them I'll always be watching and I'll be there when they fall. This is my last call. For those who served beside me and who held that thin blue line. My last call.